What's up, y'all? It's Netta Dobbins, and I am here to give you a quick tutorial around how to build a lead magnet and set up your automation funnel within ConvertKit. So let's dive in. So the first thing you need to do is create the actual form that you will be using. So to do that, you're going to go to Grow. You're going to go to Landing Pages and Forms. So there are a couple of different ways that you can do that. After creating new, you can create just a blanket form that you want to embed into your own website, or you can create an entirely new landing page that you drive people to. So I'm going to show you both ways. The first way I'm going to do is the landing page. When you click landing page, you're going to see a variety of different templates that are native to ConvertKit that you can use to start out with. Additionally, over here, you can filter by category. So we are doing this for a lead gen, a freebie type of thing. So I'm going to click ebook just to make it easier, and I'm just going to click this design. Once again, choose the design that makes the most sense for you. Once you get into the landing page template that you like, you're going to be able to edit this entire page. So here I can rewrite new lead gen or whatever, and let's say my lead gen is get my free gift guide, so on and so forth. So I can edit all of this content to talk about whatever my lead magnet is. And I keep using lead gen and lead magnet interchangeably, but we're talking about lead magnet so that we create more lead generation for your products and our services. So continue to edit all of this, and then you want to go here. This is your sign up form. And within your sign up form, you can add different fields. So of course you need their email address, and that's going to be automatically entered when you create your form, but you may also want their first name. So this is going to allow you to create new boxes. Once you create that box, you're going to be able to go here. You can either set it as a custom field or a tag or whatever, select it. So first name is something that automatically comes within ConvertKit. So click first name, make it required. Boom, you have that there. If you wanted to add anything else, once again, click that plus sign, come over here. You can make a custom field literally anything you want. So let's say none of these are what I wanted. I can just type in location, create new custom field. And now that custom field is created so that they can put in location. Once again, if this is something that you want to require, you would click make it required. And after you have completed all this, you filled in everything, you want to click publish. This is going to be your link that you steer people to. So when you are promoting your lead magnet on socials, or when you are talking in the news, podcast, whatever it is, however you're promoting your lead magnet, this is the link that you are going to want to send out or be included in the descriptions. So now we have our link, we have our form. How do we make sure that when somebody subscribes, they are automatically sent the lead magnet? You want to go into settings. Here, you want to scroll down to incentive. So your incentive is going to be your lead magnet. What are they going to get in return for signing up for your email list or whatever, or signing up to receive the lead magnet, right? It should be the lead magnet. So click incentive, click send incentive. Here you want to click download if you're sending them a PDF, in which you can do choose file, and you can upload the PDF here. And or if it is a certain website, maybe it's a YouTube video that's unlisted and it's only for, you know, certain subscribers, or maybe it's something that's on your webpage. Once again, it's unlisted, so it's only for a certain amount of people. You can click the URL and enter in the exact URL. So PDFs, photos, documents, download, choose a file, upload it to this URL, link, whatever. So once you get done with that, you will click save. You can click publish again. So So now whenever someone signs up for your newsletter, they will automatically be redirected to download the freebie. So it may be automatic download and or go to the link you specified. If you want to instead have this be sent via email, you're going to create an automation funnel. So now that we have our landing page, I'm going to rename this so I can find it. Test landing page. I will go to automations, visual automations. Click that. I'm going to create a new automation. Just like with landing pages, ConvertKit has a variety of different templates that you can utilize. I personally just like to start with an empty automation. So we're going to start from scratch. The first thing that I'm going to do is click start building. And this is going to be the trigger. What's the action that someone has to take in order for this automation to run? So because we want to send the lead magnet via email instead of having people be redirected to it, I'm going to click joins a form. And we remember, we filled out the form. We created the landing page with the form. So I'm going to scroll down to find the form. We labeled it test landing page. I'm going to click that. And I'm going to click add an event. So now when somebody subscribes to test landing page, what do I want them to do? I'm going to click the plus again, action, email sequence. So if you've already created like the email sequence that you want to use, you can of course scroll down, find whatever one it is. But if you have not, just like we did on landing page when we were doing custom fields, you can just type in the sequence that you want to create. So test landing page, I'm going to say test lead magnet email. And this email is going to be the email that is sent directly to their inbox that has the lead magnet in it. So then I'm going to click create new test lead magnet and add that action. So here I'm saying that once somebody signs up for this form, they automatically get this lead magnet. If you want to do other stuff, like maybe you want to delay it a couple of hours or something like that, you can click delay. You can select the number of days or until custom date, et cetera, et cetera. And there are a lot of other things you can do here as far as like events and conditions that we are not going to go into this video. So now test landing page, you get this test lead magnet email, but I haven't written the email. So how do I do that? I will click into this again and it's going to open up their email script, email writer. I don't know like the correct terminology for this, but it's where you write your emails. So here I can update the subject line. Here's your freebie. I can write whatever it is that I want to write here. Hi. I love personalization, so I'm always going to include their name. So hi at, which is where you can add your personalization. Subscriber first name. And I can say, thanks for subscribing. Here is your freebie. And once again, if it is a link, I can hyperlink it to go to whatever the link is. Or if it is a attachment, I can do backslash. And I'm going to scroll down until I see file. And when I see file, it's going to let me upload a specific file to this. Once it's done, I will click publish. And now my automation is set. I always recommend updating the names of everything, just so you know where to find it and what it is. ConvertKit will automatically name it something, but you want to make sure that the naming convention works with your brain, works with your business, et cetera, et cetera. So I just renamed this test automation, and then I'm going to click this back button. That's going to take me to the entire automations page. I'm going to scroll down to find the one that we just created. Bam. So when somebody subscribes to this test landing page, they will get this test lead magnet email. Two ways to do it. If you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe. Comment below if you want more ConvertKit hacks, tips, or just email marketing tips in general.